problem as well, because it is only the sunshine vitamin. You cannot get it from food. So when we look at, again, racial disparities and how you absorb vitamin D and what your vitamin D norms are, there was a really great study done in Hawaii with what we call free living people, meaning surfers, swimmers, people who work outdoors, and we looked at the different racial groups. And interestingly, African Americans cannot make as much vitamin D from the sun because your pigment in your skin prevents that vitamin D conversion from the sunlight. Interestingly, Asians are actually just above you, and then Caucasians can make the most vitamin D. So when you look at the grouping, Caucasians, free living, out in the sun, not wearing sunblock, the typical vitamin D levels are between 65 and 85 in Caucasians. And Asians, they're a little bit on the lower side of that, more like 65 to 75, and then African Americans are closer to 55 to 65. Because of your ability to make the vitamin D from the sunlight in a normal sun-exposed environment. So we also understand that if you take somebody then who has dark pigment in their skin, you move them to a climate that doesn't have sun, or they work inside, or they're covered up, or they're wearing sunblock, you're actually going to be promoting even more disease by the fact that they're really not going to be able to get the vitamin D levels that they need because of the pigment preventing the sunlight absorption. And a lot of people don't appreciate that that's completely dependent on the latitude where you live. So if you live between the Tropic of Cancer and the Tropic of Capricorn, you get optimum vitamin D production from the sunlight. The minute you move away from those, you don't have any vitamin D production at all from October to April. Even if you're out in the sun. So we're now in the month of October. It's sunny out. If you were to go outside at our latitude, even without sunblock, you would not make any vitamin D because the sun is not at the right angle for it.
Sure.
So you have 6 months you have to make up for. There's no amount of time you could spend outside to make up for it in the summer. That's why we recommend and advise vitamin D supplementation for everybody because even if you were to be outside for 6 months, it wouldn't matter because you're not going to make it. And you work inside, you're wearing clothes or sunblock or you're not outside all day.
Right.
So it's really critical to know that vitamin D number and know where your optimum number might be.
I think this also too, when I had a bout, with depression, or the season, then we discovered it was the seasonal affective disorder.
So seasonal affective disorder is very commonly vitamin D related because a lot of people don't appreciate that vitamin D is where all hormones come from and all neurotransmitters in the brain. So you start with vitamin D, you then make cholesterol, then cholesterol gets made into all of your hormones and your adrenal glands, your ovaries, your testes, etc., but also all your brain neurotransmitters. So seasonal affective disorder is most often just a vitamin D deficiency.
And I was low, but we didn't pay that. We didn't make that connection.
Very common.
Yeah.
Very
common. Now we got it. But yeah, it took us a couple years.
The first thing I tell people to do. Take some vitamin D. Which is why seasonal affective disorder is best treated with the light therapy. You know, you read about that in terms of people using natural sunlight lamps. That's why.
I have one. Thank you. Okay.